हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू 19th वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोस्टैट्स। दिस वीडियो लेक्चर विल प्रोसीड विद लाइन इंटीग्रल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, वर्क डन बाय इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इट इज। नेगेटिव लाइन इंटीग्रल, व्हाट रिटन ओवर हियर, लेट्स रीड इट आउट। Negative line integral of electric field represents the work done by the electric field on a unit positive charge in moving it from one point to another point in the electric field. Okay, so how much work is done on a unit positive charge? Okay, to move it from one point to another point, that work done will be equal to the negative line integral of electric field. Line integral of electric field we have already discussed. It is represented by integration E dot dl. So let's express it mathematically. If you have to move a charge from point A to point B, then work done to move the charge from A to B, WAB equal to integration of dw equal to minus integration vector E dot dl from A to B, right? Let's understand with the diagram. Let's have the Cartesian planes XY, YZ and ZX. A positive charge plus Q is kept at the origin O, and these are the points from where to where the charge has to be moved from point A to point B, right? Now the position vectors of point A and B are vector RA and vector RB, and we have to move the charge from A to B like this. Okay, so this is a test charge plus Q naught, and due to this positive charge, source charge, the force on test charge plus Q naught will be in outward direction, because these both of these charges are positive in nature, so that's why outward force. And this is the position vector of this test charge, vector R. Now let's Q naught be the test charge in place of the unit positive charge. At the place of unit positive charge, we are taking charge Q naught. The force F, vector F, is equal to plus Q naught vector E acts on the test charge due to the source charge plus Q, right? So how much force will be exerted on plus Q naught? That will be equal to plus Q naught vector E, because this particular test charge is placed in the electric field of the source charge plus Q. Okay, so that's why this is the force. It is radially outward because both the charges are of positive nature and tends to accelerate the test charge. Definitely force will accelerate this test charge in this direction, right? To prevent this acceleration, equal and opposite force minus Q naught E has to be applied on the test charge. If you want to retain this test charge over here only, so equal and opposite force has to be applied on this plus Q charge. Plus Q naught charge, that is equal to minus Q naught E, opposite direction. So that's why this minus sign is there, right? So total work done by the electric field on test charge in moving it from A to B in the electric field is WAB is equal to integration dW, same thing, minus integration of vector E dot dl from A to B. And this, when we'll integrate, after putting the values of E, value of E, will obtain QQ naught upon 4 pi epsilon naught bracket 1 upon RB minus 1 upon RA, right? Next, so therefore work done to move the charge from A to B, integration of dW is equal to minus integration of vector E dot dl from A to B is equal to QQ naught upon 4 pi epsilon naught bracket 1 by RB minus 1 by RA. So now what are the conclusions of this particular expression? First, the equation shows that work done in moving a test charge Q naught from point A to another point B along any path AB in an electric field due to plus Q charge depends only on the positions of these points and is independent of the actual path followed between A and B. Okay, so you can see RB and RA show the position of the Q naught, from where to where the Q naught has to be moved. It does not this expression does not contain anything which shows the dependence on the path through which the charge is being moved. So therefore, this work done is independent of the path through which the charge is being moved, only initial and final positions. Second is connected to the first one only, that is the line integral of electric field is path independent. We have seen only positions are shown over here, or we can say these RB and RA show the or indicate the positions of Q naught from where to where it has to be moved. So therefore, line integral of electric field is path independent. Next, therefore, electric field is conservative field. Why conservative field? Because when work done by any force is path independent, then this definitely that force is conservative force, and the force is created due to a field. And if the force is conservative force, therefore the field will also be which kind of field? Conservative field. Fourth, line integral of electric field over a closed path is zero, because the charge has to return to its initial position. Okay, so therefore RB and RA both are same in that case. So therefore, line integral of electric field over a closed path is zero. This is another condition satisfied by the conservative field. This also shows that this is which kind of field? This is conservative field. Now, integration of vector E dot dl from A to B over a closed path, because the charge is reaching to its initial position. So in that case, this particular expression will be equal to zero. This shows the closed path, right? Note, the line integral of only static field is independent of the path followed. Remember it. We are only talking about which kind of field? Static field, right? Static field. So work done will be path independent in the case of static field only, but line integral of the field due to moving charge is not independent of the path, because the field varies with time. So this is very important discussion, that if the field is varying, and when field will vary, then the charge will keep on moving. So for time varying field, or when the field varies with time, the line integral of field due to a moving charge, in that case due to a moving charge, is not path independent, right? Next. Now, electric potential. Electric potential is the topic which you have all studied in class 10th in a touch and go situation, because it was given at a very small extent. There is a much long elaboration, or we can say you will study in this particular topic in this class in a much elaborated mode. So let's elaborate what the electric potential is. Electric potential is a physical quantity which determines the flow of charges from one body to another body. Okay, so heat flow, when the temperature difference is there between two bodies, then heat starts to flow. We studied in class 11th. Similarly, when the charges have to flow from one body to another body, the difference in potential describes that, and difference in temperature describes the heat flow. Okay, similar behavior. Okay, it is a physical quantity that determines the degree of electrification of a body. How much body is being charged, that also shows the electric, that is also shows by the electric potential. Let us read the most important terminology of electric potential. Electric potential at a point in the electric field is defined as the work done in moving, okay, without acceleration.
the charge should be moved in uniform way. There should be no acceleration. Okay. So how it can be calculated? The electric potential at a point in the electric field is defined as the work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to a given point or to that point against the electrostatic force irrespective of the path followed. Okay. So whatever be the path, does not matter if the charge is being moved from infinity. Okay. The infinity is a point which is not determined, from anywhere to a given point in the electric field of the given charge. So how much work is done with respect to a unit positive charge, that determines the electric potential. Okay, that is the meaning of this definition. And work done expression, we have already studied this, we have already derived in the last slide. So electric potential VAB equal to WAB upon Q naught. If we divide this particular expression by Q naught, because work done per unit test charge is described as the electric potential, so we can write WAB upon Q naught, and that is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught 1 upon RB minus 1 upon RA. Right? So according to definition, if RA is equal to infinite, because in the definition there is a case that charge has to be moved from infinity to a given point, and RB is equal to R, given point's position is R, okay, where R is the distance from the source charge in the electric field of the source charge, okay, at the point which where we have to calculate the electric potential, and that is the point of consideration, right? So therefore W infinity to B upon Q naught is equal to, when we'll put these values, RA is equal to infinite, this term will become 0. So therefore we can write Q upon, and RB is equal to R, so we can write Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught R, and that is equal to V. This is electric potential expression, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R, right? So therefore we can write V is equal to W infinity to B upon Q naught, and if we discuss the unit of electric potential, then definitely it can be written as joule per coulomb, because work done's unit is joule and charge unit is what? Coulomb. So joule per coulomb is the unit of electric potential, right? Now this is the line electric potential, or we can say conclusion of the derivation and discussion. Electric potential at a point is 1 volt if 1 joule of work is done in moving 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to that point in the electric field. So actually it is a definition of 1 volt potential. So what is 1 volt potential? This is the definition, that electric potential at a point is 1 volt if 1 joule of work is done in moving 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to that point in the electric field. Right? So, in this video lecture, we have discussed the electric potential, we have discussed the work done, and we have got that electrostatic force is a conservative force, and electrostatic field is a conservative field. So, many more topics are left in second part of electrostats, but those topics and further more topics will elaborate in next video lecture. Till that time, keep on studying, keep on working hard. Thank you so much for paying attention.